Okay, hey folks, I'm gonna show you how to make GIFs using just Adobe Photoshop and QuickTime Player. Oh, yep, that's right, QuickTime Player has a purpose now. You've probably never used it for anything or never had to use it for anything because it's done nothing for a long time, but right now, the first thing we're gonna do is download Perian. Perian will basically turn QuickTime into VLC, so it'll play, you know, whatever type of weird file you're trying to watch. So just install that real quick. It's a quick install. It's just an extension for QuickTime. And then once you have all that installed and everything, we can go to our YouTube video that we want. In this case, I'm going to be using Unchained Melody, the pottery scene from Ghost with Patrick Swayze. And I just want something kind of like that. Looks good to me. So what I'm going to do is go to QuickTime Player, and I'm going to go to File, and then I'm going to make a new screen recording, and I can't do it right here, as you can see, because I'm currently doing that to make this instructional video. So, you're going to click that and click record, and this little stop recording button will appear at the top. So whenever you're ready to stop recording, you can just click that and it'll save. And so play your video once you're recording the screen. And you want something like that. So just let it run for a little while. It's okay to have more than you want at this point because we can always trim it later. So yeah, we'll do something like that and I'll click stop recording. And then what's going to happen is a little save as screen will pop up, which is not going to on mine because I'm still recording. But you're going to save as a MOV. And in this case, I'm going to call it ghost. .mov, and I'm going to open it with QuickTime. So open up QuickTime and go to File, go to Open File, and I'm going to find my ghost, open it up, and so we'll play it in QuickTime just to show you. It's basically all it is a video of your screen watching ghost. So I'm making a video of me making a video watching Ghost with Patrick Swayze. Then what you're going to do is go to Edit, I'm sure, and go to Trim. And we're going to take out all the bullshit that you don't want lengthwise, as far as length is concerned. So just these are the borders. You can drag them to make your, you know, to make your play area small, to make it long. I want to get that O face right there. See the O face that he makes? I want the O face, and I want the weird phallic clay thing. And then click trim, and it'll trim it down. This is a 2 second long GIF. Perfect. That is a perfect looking GIF. I love it. So then what we're going to do is go to File, Save As, and Save As Movie. That's a .mov. And saving. And then you can just get out of this and you'll never use that again. Go to Adobe Photoshop. Go to File. And you're going to go down to Import, Video Frames to Layers, and go to ghost.mov. And if you want the best quality, select beginning to end. If you feel like you could sacrifice some quality for the benefit of having a smaller file size, because a lot of sites, you know, have a limit on file size, you can do limit to every X amount of frames. So if you do 2, it's essentially gonna be excuse me. I have to quit smoking. Let's see. If you limit to every 2 frames, then what's basically going to happen is it's going to be twice as fast and not as good a quality, but probably not really noticeable. If you do something like every 3 or 4 frames, it's probably going to ruin the GIF. So just select beginning to end in this case. All right. And that's going to take a second to load up. It's going to load all the frames. And we have essentially the whole screen as you were watching it in your browser. So first thing we're going to do is get rid of the terrible looking, awful, bullshit browser YouTube thing. And you're going to use your crop tool. Just crop that out real quick. And then you'll just have a perfect looking section of video. Just deselect your crop tool. So get out of that. And what we're going to want to do is basically figure out how we want our GIF to be. Do we want it to be high quality? Do we want it to be short, long? First thing we're going to have to deal with is the frame rate. Right now, as you can see, each frame is 0.07 seconds long. So when we play it, each frame there is 0.07 seconds long. We can select all of the frames by selecting the first frame, then finding the last frame, and holding the shift and clicking it. And then when you select this little arrow at the bottom here, you can select how long you want your GIF to be, or how long you want each frame to be, rather. And I'm going to guesstimate that 0.15 seconds should be pretty good. That should be close. You don't want it to be so fast that it just clips through, but you don't want it to be so slow that it's choppy. You'll find a balance after playing around for a while. I feel like it could go... No, that's perfect. That's actually... That's pretty much right on point. And then if you want to get rid of some frames just to make it, you know, not so long, if you want a shorter GIF, maybe you can take out the first 5 frames or so by selecting the first one, holding shift, selecting the 5th one, clicking the trash can, and then it'll just get rid of those first 5 frames. That's a perfect GIF if I've ever seen one. That is good. And then you can basically save at this point. If you want to make text or something like that, you can just use your text tool, make a new layer, and bring it all the way to the top, and then just type in whatever you want. We'll type in owned. And then, since it's on the top there, it should appear in every layer. Owned. Okay. And then when you're ready to save, you can go to Save for Web, or it might be called Save for Web and Devices. And then in this screen, you're basically going to get the GIF to be the right file size, because a lot of the times the websites won't allow certain file sizes. They'll have limits, usually like 1 or 2 megs, something like that. First off, this is way too big, so you can bring it down to like 50% right there. And that brings us down to 992.4K. So that's good. That's perfect. That's right where we need to be. But if you need to play around with the GIF a little bit more just to get it to the right file size, you can also decrease or increase the amount of colors it uses. If you want to bring it down, like 256 is kind of unnecessary. If you bring it to 128, you barely even notice a difference in the actual quality, but it will make a substantial difference with the file size. Basically, all this is just trying to find a balance between quality and file size. So when you're ready, you just click save and save it as ghost owned dot gif. Doesn't even make sense, not even funny. And then you have your gif and you should be able to post it wherever you want to post it and go anywhere in life. I guess that's really it for the tutorial. Thank you for tuning in. I hope you make fun GIFs and enjoy the rest of your day. Bye now.